Does the city have a reasonable good faith anticipation of securing an arrest or prosecution in the foreseeable future after 13 years?
With that, he ordered OPD to turn over the case files to the new judge hearing the case by noon January 12th for a court-only review, which appeared to satisfy the case.
Well, I would hope that those leads will then be followed up and worked through.
We know this actually made a mistake, but that has absolutely nothing to do with this right now. The number one thing that we're trying to do is find Jessica.
The judge will be inspecting the Orlando Police investigative records less than 2 weeks before the 13th anniversary of Jennifer Kessie's disappearance. In Orange County, Greg Fox, Rush TV.
He turned that camera on.
Can you even imagine? It was horrifying. A family in Houston, Texas said when a man hacked into their baby cam, he was watching them, they say, and watching the nursery and threatening to take their child. These parents say they first heard the man saying sexually explicit things in the monitor before making a threat. They then ran to the infant's room and found the child was alone and sleeping soundly. Now, the company thinks the camera Nest is blaming this on poor password security by the users, and Nest is alerting affected customers to reset passwords and set up two-factor authentication.
Makes you feel invaded and uncomfortable.
The family has filed a police report, but it is unlikely the hacker will ever be caught, authorities say.
President Trump's charitable foundation has been dissolved. The foundation was started by Trump years before he became a presidential candidate. But yesterday's news came following a lawsuit by New York's attorney general claiming that the president misused the foundation to advance his campaign in 2016. New York's attorney general says that the foundation